Welcome to Workbench 5, Domo's on-premise data integration tool. From the homepage, we can see the success rates for our jobs, total executions, total row counts, and our total uploaded data. We can navigate back to this area anytime by clicking the Home button on the left. Below the homepage, we have the Accounts page, where we can view the status of our accounts. It is easy to find account information such as the machine name, our Domo domain, and the authenticator of this Workbench agent. We can easily add a new account by clicking the Add button. Next, we have our Jobs page. Here, we can see our job statuses and other information. We can create a new job on the List view by clicking the Add button. Jobs from all Domo accounts are here and can be filtered to what we are looking for. Let's filter to just our marketing jobs and double-click into the Marketing Contacts job. From here, the different tabs help us to configure our jobs. The Overview tab shows general information about our job. Here we can see if our job ran successfully and how many rows were updated. The Configure tab is where we define how to connect, read, transform, and process the data to be loaded into Domo. In this case, the data is a file on our computer, but if we have a job that connects to a database, we can modify the query under Processing. Finally, we're able to select our update method, either replace or append. Transforms allow us to clean up our data before it is imported into Domo. For this job, we have a custom date format, shift date time zone, and custom calculation to generate a batch ID. Impersonation allows Workbench to connect the data as a specific user, and Additional Settings has a few options that help with uploading our data. The Schedule tab allows us to define when our Workbench jobs run. Under Basic Schedule, we have the option to update manually, when the file is changed, or on a static schedule. For additional scheduling options, we can click on Advanced Schedule. These additional options include scheduling the update for a specific time of day and more dynamic update intervals such as day, week, and month. However, because this is a file on our computer, we're going to select Update when file is changed. Moving on to the Schema tab, we can see all the columns and data types in the job as well as select which columns to include in the dataset. We can also rename columns here. The Notifications tab lets us set who gets notified after a job runs. We can select whether a user will be notified of a success or error. Once the dataset has been created and run, the History tab appears and allows for easy navigation to diagnostic information about the Workbench job. We can go directly to the dataset from Workbench, and we can also see the logs for this job. Across the top right are the Action buttons. At any time within the Filtered Jobs view, we can preview, save, revert our changes, execute, or delete the job. Next, we have the More page. Within the page, there are many sections. The first is Proxy. If a special network configuration is required when communicating with Domo, we can set the values here. From Settings, we can manage security, configure how jobs are run on the computer, manage automatic updates, and choose our preferred language. Next, we have Plugins. These tools can make it easier to manipulate and import data. Custom plugins can also be installed here. From Import, we can import previously backed up jobs. And Export allows us to back up the current state of our jobs. From the Log Viewer, we can view a detailed history of Workbench's actions. In Legacy Schedules, there's a link to documentation detailing how to use the Workbench CLI tool. The Group Scheduler allows us to perform multiple scheduling tasks at once. Let's create a new group schedule by clicking the Add button. First, we'll choose the jobs we want to be in our group. Note that they only appear here if they are on a manual schedule and not included in other groups. The Workbench jobs can run at the same time, or we can choose the specific order we want them to run. If any job marked critical fails, any subsequent jobs will not run. Next, we'll define our schedule. And finally, we'll give the group a name and click Done. Down at the bottom of the left navigation is the Data Sync icon. Data Sync allows us to select a local folder, and Workbench will automatically create jobs for Excel and CSV files that are placed within it. Next is the Preview window. This button displays the detailed output of previews along with a preview of the data. Finally, we have the Help button. Here, the information needed to accomplish tasks is linked directly from Workbench. With Workbench 5, you can quickly connect your on-premise data to Domo.